You may be familiar with signs like these, but in downtown Phoenix, amongst these flowers, something not so sweet is on display.
And I was a little surprised because you don't really see campaign signs that are a little crasser. I think there's a reason they put them here. It's a college campus. They think it's going to be funny and connect with the youth vote.
But it's not just on campus where people are seeing the unmarked signs. North on Central, many signs, all with the same message, are easy to spot.
Obviously, these signs are childish.
Over at Fred DeVal's quarters, communication director Jeff Vetter says that their campaign is not responsible for the signs.
It just distracts from the message. You know, we want this campaign to be about the issues that are important, creating jobs for Arizonans, fixing our kids' schools, and this is just a silly distraction.
They are not only a distraction, but they are also unmarked. And they may be in violation of city code. Number 5 of the AZ Statute 161019 states that the campaign signs contains the name and telephone number or website address of the candidate or campaign committee contact person.
No, I think it's really bad that they don't have any contact info in there, and if they don't follow the campaign regulations, they definitely should be taken down before the votes.
We called the city of Phoenix to alert them of the unmarked signs.
We do what we can to get out there as soon as possible, and I make sure that my staff has it on their radar at all times that these things come up. This is the season.
Many just want to know who is behind these ads.
We should be able to see who is sponsoring these signs. How do we get in contact? If someone did have a problem with that sign, who would they be able to talk to?
For now, that answer is unknown. And as the countdown for the midterm elections continues, we will see how these signs may or may not have an impact.